Yeah, of course, Latin America is such a big and diverse continent that we can find all the models. We can find on Brazil, like a kind of right wing, and in Mexico, a left wing. And also we have the humanitarian crisis of Venezuela that we have to talk about. And of course, all the feelings and all the possibilities are going on in Latin America. First, I have to agree with the predecessors that talk about the globalization like something that is going on. And they mention two dimensions. One is the technological, the science, the innovation that are in our hands, in our kids' hands. And also the economic issues that even with all these barriers that sometimes happens, but they are going on. The capital is circulating, and we know the commerce is going on. But I want to add a new, also another aspect that is about environmental issues. Because in the previous panel, they were talking about a kind of eco-skeptical view about what's happening with the world in terms of environmental or sustainable goals and things like that. But even in that field, you feel that globalization is there. Because if something happens in Europe, it will affect, for example, Latin America. Of if we do something with the Amazon basin, the biggest basin in the world, it can affect the other part of the world in terms of how is the weather and how it will impact in biodiversity and possibilities in other parts of the world. Then we have at least three areas where globalization is very present: the technological area, the financial area or economic area, and also the environmental. At least we can not also not pay attention with what's happening in terms of nations in local issues. Then I always proposed in some years ago that maybe globalization can evolve, an evolution of globalization. And when we need different words for different concepts, the license in terms of using of language are done, then we can talk about global issues, not only global issues. And I think that global issues is a kind of evolution of global, because we have to pay attention about the feelings of the people in each country. Each nation has the right to preserve identity, because the local is identity. It has to deal with culture, with gastronomy, with religion, with feelings of the people. That is the identity of people. That is the local. And of course, every one of us can say something about his traditions, or Poland, or Bulgaria, or other countries, or Ecuador. We have to say something. But at the same time, we are with this globalization that is there and is going to continue there. Then how we can manage and handle the identity of the people with the globalization? Because, of course, in global issues, we can lose part of our identity. And that is the thing that is breaking, and people is feeling that something is happening because we are not respecting the others. Respect is a very important word and a very important concept. Then, if we mix the global benefits with all the, in all this area that we mentioned, and we maintain the identity, the respect, the local, we can mix global and local and build this that is not so new, because it has been during some years, this new world global with a new concept about global, how we preserve identities and how we continue with globalization that had made a lot for humanity. We feel here the examples that the previous panelists talk about, but I can tell a lot also about Ecuadorian banana arriving to Azerbaijan or Ecuadorian roses being in places like all Europe or even in other places too, and how we can manage this with globalization. We were talking about Brexit a few minutes ago, and I feel that when we talk about UK, UK was the first globalized country with Queen Victoria's boat going all around the world. Then we feel globalization is going since long time ago, and it will continue, but preserve the identity maybe will avoid a lot of friction and a lot of problems.